They just have these young, inexperienced kids that are not electricians, pulling them out, slapping them in, pulling them out, slapping them in. And that's just not right when we have such kind of safety issues that are not being followed, especially for like Sun Village. That's ridiculous that they're gonna be in there doing what they're doing. The only job qualifications that they advertised for was a clean driver's record, no felony convictions, and either a high school diploma or GED equivalent. Which is ridiculous when you're looking at the safety issues of the equipment that they are playing with. Even journeyman electricians are shocked by what they did. I have talked to one journeyman electrician contractor who said that originally the company that was contracted to do installation was gonna have and follow state law and regulations. There is a state law that specifically requires on any electrical contract work that a licensed journeyman electrician be present in a one-to-one basis for safety reasons. Because only a licensed journeyman electrician will be able to tell you whether or not that box is safe to pull a meter off and slap something new on it. That's the only person that can tell you that. If you do not have that experience, you won't know whether or not it's safe to put it in there. I've talked to another retired journeyman electrician who was working on his mother's house in Kalia, a house that's very old, and he was going to change out the actual electrical box itself because it was so rusted away. There's so much salt air in Kalia. And he was afraid to even remove the old meter. Every time he'd open it up, he'd find another part that was rusted through that needed replacing. So he's goes down to the electrical store to pick up more parts before he actually starts the removing of the box, replace all of the rusted out material within the box, and then put the meter back on, because that's the safest way to do it. When he got back, a smart meter had already been slapped on, to his shock and surprise. Because the person doing it is not an electrician, the person doing it doesn't know that this could be extremely, it is extremely dangerous to have put a brand new device in there. In a system that was already aging and problematic, that even a journeyman electrician was afraid to touch. In California alone, many of the actual electric company workers are very unhappy with the whole setup, because what they're doing is following installers and fixing their mistakes. And you can read story after story after story after story. I've literally read hundreds of them, where people's houses have been put in danger from a faulty install. The same thing is right now happening here. Next problem with having inexperienced installers. They are paid on commission. They have a small hourly wage because they're not electricians. But they get bonuses by installing more than their required iota of meters. So they're in a huge rush going from neighborhood to neighborhood to neighborhood to put on as many smart meters as possible so they get a bigger commission bonus paycheck. One, they don't know what they're doing because they're inexperienced and not electricians. Two, their motivation is not to put these in correctly, is to put them in as fast as possible. And from what I've heard so far, even if you have put in a deferral notice, they're not really checking their notes on who they're supposed to put it on and who they're not supposed to put it on. And I've had several people where they are on the deferral list and the installer comes by and tries to put on a meter on their home and says, no, I'm deferred. Well, you're not on my list. Yes, I am. And they make a phone call. Oh, yeah, you're right. Each installer is supposed to knock on a resident's door to inform them that we're here to change out your meter. At that moment, you can say no. You don't even have to have a deferral form on your hand. You don't even have to have a deferral form in with them. You can say, nope, I'm going to be doing a deferral. At that moment, the installer is supposed to hand you a card with the information on how to get the deferral notice and walk away. That has not been happening. I'm finding that the installers, one, do not knock on the door, two, are in a huge rush to put in as many smart meters as possible, and they are not talking to the residents or trying to inform them that a meter change is going to be taking place, which again brings up safety issues. Or if you are like me that have computer equipment in your home that you work from, that messes up a lot of things, especially if you're not on a battery backup. So there's many, many different things that they're doing wrong. We do have the remedies in place now because we really pushed them on it by saying, okay, you guys are doing this. Are you going to stand up here saying we have no deadline on this deferral? When can we defer? Can we defer after it's been installed? Can we defer when they decide at that moment to to not have it installed? Can they think about it for 3 days and then decide not to have it installed? What is the stance of KIUC? And I got confirmation back today from Jim Kelly, the communications manager of KIUC. If at any time after an installation you decide to defer, call them, fill out the deferral form, get it out there to them. They will replace that meter with a old analog or old electronic that is not a smart meter. That's another big step in our direction. So now that we got them in writing stating this, you do not have a deadline. It was never a deadline. We can take our choice back from these installers that are running around just trying to make another buck. Sir, in the back, you had your hand up first.
I'm sorry, I came in a little late. I'm sorry if you have to repeat. What's the process to opt out? You go down to KIUC and sign something?
I got a deferral form right on the back shelf.
There you go.
Fill it out, give it to them, so you do not want a smart meter on your home.
And is that a done deal?
And that's a done deal. If they do come to your house and accidentally, as they say, put a smart meter on you, contact them immediately, say that you're deferred, they'll take it off. But if you're at home and they try to do it, you can always tell them, no, I'm deferred, do not do it, and they're going to walk away, and you're safe.
And in the case that I told you about my tenants?
Yep. Tell them that you were in the process of deferring it. I want this thing removed. Here's my deferral. Take it off immediately. But make sure you contact Jim Kelly via email and phone call. Keep a documented record of it, because we want to keep them honest. And that's the only way we can keep them honest, is by keeping documents, having written records of this. Yes?
What's the skinny on the surcharge that they want to charge for people that have deferrals?
That is a fear tactic. Right now, KIUC cannot charge you anything for deferring. They will have to first have a board meeting to discuss the fee that they may come up with. After that board meeting, they would have to go to the PUC and convince them why they would have to have this fee imposed upon the public or imposed upon the co-op members. Before any of that can happen, we as the members can always have a referendum vote to shut it down, and we will. We got way more than enough numbers to shut that down. By standing up, by saying no, you completely short-circuit the whole thing.
Clean up your
and all it takes is one person to stand up and say no. That's all it takes. And then others notice it. And now you have this whole ripple effect going outwards. Because one person touches another person, touches another person. My sister-in-law alone has touched hundreds of people with this. Just one person has touched hundreds. So even though you may only communicate the information to one person, you don't know how many people that person is going to touch. And that's the power that we have right now, by just standing up and saying no and presenting the actual facts to the public.